Would like to hang on to it, maybe, Gary Jacobs.
58 seconds remaining. Bombers by a point. This sensational team from Windy Hill, but it comes down to Tivendale. Squeeze it, get move! It's Penabuck! Penabuck's on the ball, he kicks to Getu! Richo goes up, he can't take the mark! That's a fall of the ball! Here's a chance for Coglan! Taken down, and Johnson's been fantastic tonight! Mark Johnson kicks it out! The Bombers have got the run! Bolton holds it up!
Good head.
Inside 30, they're going to hang on, you think the Bombers maybe from here?
That is a good head from Bolton, because when you're running with momentum, and there's a lot of emotion in it, the temptation is to keep going like Jacobs did earlier.
Well, this is the kick for the night. All he has to do is hit a target here or make sure he doesn't turn it over. And the Bombers are going to hang on here. Inside 10 seconds. The Bombers by 1 point. Handballs off and Carousella says, thank goodness for that. Essendon hang on. Well, against the odds in the end, this has been a fantastic hard-fought victory for the Bombers. Not one for Kevin Chidio's video collection, but I'll tell you what, the 4 points go back to Windy Hill. And Danny Brawley says it all for the Tigers.
They've won kicking 2 goals in the second half, Ed.
They have indeed. In fact, 3 goals since... Well, the 3 goals came 1 minute 50 into the second quarter. And then 4 minutes and 22 minutes into the final quarter, Matthew Knights doesn't get the dream ending that he'd hoped for. He's with Tony Jones.
Thanks very much, Eddie. Well, unfortunately not the Tiger song, but geez, the boys gave it their best shot. As Paul Salmon comes over now and congratulates Matty Knights. Matty, it was just ripper stuff out there.
Yeah, the boys with 3 or 4 goals down. And they really, really turned the heat up, the boys, for me. They chased, they scratched, they clawed, and we got back into the game. And we just couldn't finish off, you know. Bombers, to their credit, they had on tough too. But, you know, I'm just proud to play my last game for this great club. Ever since 1988, I've embraced the club. And I really do love this club. And I think this club is going places, even though we've lost our last 7 or 8. It is going places. And disappointing to lose, but the boys had a real crack for
me. Has it really hit home now, has it, Matty? It's all over?
It'll probably hit home this week when I go to pick up my footy bag and I've got no training to go to and stuff like that. So... yeah, it's probably hitting home. It's the last time I'll see the Richmond crowd.
I think James Hurt certainly wants to wish you all the best. Good on, terrific stuff. Very emotional down here, Eddie, as you can imagine. Matty Knights leaving the arena for the last time.
Thanks very much, Barry Tony Young. Jones and Barry Young, old teammate, and Kevin Morris, an old Tiger himself, coming over to congratulate. Well, one of the great from Punt Road in Matthew Knights. But let's not forget that the Bombers have hung on tonight. They've gritted it out to win by a point. And they can reload now, and the Bombers can set sail for September, because halfway through that last quarter, it looked like it could have been all over for them.
Indeed it could, Eddie, and they found a bit. They probably won't take a lot out. As Matty Knights runs a lap of honour, and that's a nice way to go out. I mean, the wind behind him would have been the icing on the cake. Goes over, and thanks to the Richmond coaching staff, of course, played a big role in his footy career this season. Obviously made some tough calls on him. It's character building stuff, and he should just savour this.
Yeah, it's a wonderful thing these days in football. Once upon a time, all footballers were supposed to remain stoic right throughout their career, but now we're getting a little bit of emotion into it. And we saw last year when Gary Hocking took 3 hours to do his last lap.
Essendon has paid out for him, Ed, yeah. And the Essendon fans showing their appreciation for a great career
right
as well.
Kane Benefer, talk about emotion in footy. A young kid who, in his second year, is farewelling one of the Richmond greats, and you can never say it doesn't touch players in a way that perhaps we don't appreciate at times.
And the Bombers move over to the vendor, Kevin Sheedy, who understands for the history of the game and the emotion of the game and just how hard it is to play 279 games.
That is fantastic.
Takes his Bombers over, and congratulations to the Essendon Football Club and Kevin Sheedy
for
the tribute they pay to a great man in Matthew Knights. That's what football's all about. He's still got the blood pouring from his head after being opened up by an Essendon knee, and they say congratulations to him. Right under Matthew Knights as he does his lap of honour.
Good photo with the last jumper with the blood dripping down the Richmond sash. Derm, there's a bit of romance about that.
There's his mum, gives him a kiss, and
Well, that's the way you want to go off, don't you? You'd love to have the 4 points, but over with his wife and his son and family. A bit of claret from the head for the last time, as you said. You'll hang up that jumper with a bit of red on it. And, well, a wonderful experience for a bloke who deserves it. A captain of the club between 1997 and 2000. Best and fairest in 1990 and 1992. Runner-up in 95 and 98. All-Australian in 1998. 279 games after making his debut in 1988. And 141 career goals. Matthew Knight says goodbye to this Coliseum that is the MCG and the Tiger Army. Thanks for the memories, number 33. And there have been plenty, and they've been fantastic.
Begs the question too, Ed. He played very well tonight.
He did. He did have a very good night. He had an influence on this game early in the piece. Probably kept him in it. As well, the Richmond supporters... Yeah, love them or hate them, but they're nice to have on your side. They make as much noise as anyone. Dermot, tell us the story from a possession point of view, because he had a fair bit of it.
Yeah, well, he had 11 kicks, 10 handballs. So he's come home with 21 disposals in his swan song there. 6 marks, and he also took the ball inside his forward 50 on 3 occasions. He had a fantastic evening.
No doubt about that. A 1-point victory to the Bombers, but the night will be remembered. For Matthew Knights, his farewell performance, he went out a champion tonight. No doubt about that. The Tigers almost pinched it, coming from the depths of despair in season 2002. And even at half-time, they looked absolutely shot to pieces, 23 points down. Hit the front by 3 points at three-quarter time, and they couldn't hold off the Bombers, who won by 1 point. For the record, there have been 4 1-point results this season. What a season it's been. And the final accolade to a champion to be cheered from the arena.
Into the crowd.
'88, he turned up at Punt Road and Tony Jewell couldn't believe this young skinny boy from Mildura.
He fit comfortably, I reckon, in modern day midfielders. And that's a very nice send-off. The Richmond faithful have hung around in big numbers. And he was a quality player at every level. I think that's the thing that struck me about him. He'd go into state footy and be just as comfortable as he was playing in the home and away stuff. He was he had some serious skills, Dermot. His vision was probably... You can't measure vision, but he saw it unfold as well as anyone.
Farewell, Matthew Knights. You've done your club and your family proud. We'll take a break. We'll come back and talk to the Bombers about their hang tough win by 1 point over the Tigers at the MCG. 7-12-54 to 7-11-53. It had everything.